Hi Sagittarius, welcome to Omkara Tarot and to your weekly reading of You and Yours. This is for the 25th of May till the 31st of May. Sagittarian, these are energy readings, so don't get fixated on the dates. Time is fluid, which means these are energies which are around you. You could have just experienced this, are going through this, or will experience this in your immediate future. Also, please know these are general energies, so will not resonate with each and every one of you. So please take what works for you and leave the rest. In case you need a private reading one-on-one, you can contact me at omkaratarot@gmail.com. So let's begin your reading. Sagittarius, dear God, goddesses, angels, spirit guides, please bless this reading for Sagittarius and send us the message Sagittarians need to hear the most. Thank you. Now, Sagittarius, this is a reading for you and yours. That means you and the person who's affecting your energy most at this point. These are not specific love readings. So that means, you know, one side could be you, one side could be maybe your father or a child or a neighbor or a boss or somebody. And how those energies are affecting you and how you can deal with them. So, but of course, a love interest could also show up here, who knows. But I will be doing specific love readings soon as well. So subscribe to the channel. You know, you'll be notified whenever I upload them. Let's see what comes through this time. Bottom of the deck, I have the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. So the first card I have here for you is the Wheel of Fortune in reverse. Two of Wands. The Fool, Eight of Swords, Ten of Cups, and the King of Pentacles. Wonderful. The other side is Strength, the other person. Five of Wands, Three of Wands, the Empress, King of Wands, and the Five of Pentacles. Mutual energy, death, rebirth, Page of Swords, and the Queen of Wands. Okay, Sagittarius, let's see. Okay, now I'll be reading one side is person A, the other side is person B. So you have to see which is your side, which is the side you resonate with, and use your discernment regarding who the other person is who's affecting your energy right now. So Sagittarius, I see from, let's see, person one. Person one seems to be in a kind of a stagnant place right now, feeling things are not easy, things are not going in their favor right now. They really desperately want the Wheel of Fortune to move forward, you know, and their luck is not changing. They are just waiting, seeing what else is out there, but unable to, you know, they're feeling very bound and stuck right now. Even though they feel they really are looking forward to a fresh start, or they're seeing somebody else take a fresh start, which is leaving them really stressed out. And they feel that, you know, the Wheel of Fortune is not in their favor. I have the Wheel of Fortune once again. So they feel maybe that the Wheel of Fortune is not working for them, but looking at maybe somebody else who's taken a fresh new start, who looks happy and has moved away from them. This is leading to a lot of stress in their life. They're not liking what they're seeing. Why I say this is because I have the Page of Swords in the center of the spread, right? Page of Swords is a spying card. You seem to be both kind of maybe watching each other from a distance, something which has come to an end, and you want to see where the other person is, what they're doing with their new life, and you feel cheated as to, you know, like, how come the Wheel of Fortune is not in your favor? There was some kind of commitment which came to an end, probably, and maybe in the past this did give you a lot of happiness, and you felt totally in control, but then it all stopped for you, okay? The happy, joyous times all came to a crashing halt, and the wish fulfillment that you felt with this person. Spirit, why is there a King of Pentacles in person A's? Too many cards have come out. Why is the king? Okay, I've got two. So, yeah, so the King of Pentacles wanted to stay in control, okay? They wanted to stay in control of their home, family, stability, but that somehow came crashing down. The person they felt they had the stability with, probably this Queen of Pentacles, who was a nurturer, giver, who took care of them maybe. She, bottom of the deck, I have her in reverse, right? So maybe this person left and they were not happy about that. And they keep keeping an eye out on them to see them move on. And this is not making them happy at all. There was too much confusion. And maybe there were other people involved, too many other people involved. This Knight of Wands was not the most reliable. I mean, one person in this dynamic was not very reliable. They were confused. They were lazy. They didn't want to take, action maybe. And let's see how the other person is feeling. The other person seems very defensive at the moment. The other person seems totally defensive, is staying very strong, okay? They're standing in that position. They are defending themselves. They seem to have reached a certain height where they are warding off anyone unwanted attention. And they are also in a place where they, you know, if there was any resistance or any conflict in the relationship, they are wanting to let go of all that. They are standing in their power right now as the Empress, okay? This Empress is, yes, they want to release whatever happened. They are wanting to release all this tension, stress, wanting to release any fights that there were, any conflicts that they had with anybody else. They are waiting. Now, they've turned their back. They've turned their back and they are looking out at the see to see these new ships come in, and they're waiting to see what new will come into their life. Right now, the Empress also suggests that, you know, they have closed the last chapter of their life. They feel this is over, and they've turned the face away. But they are trying to find growth and happiness and, whatever they want in life by themselves, because they felt there was no more love left in the relationship. And there was no fresh start to be given, because this King of Swords, who's in reverse, he did not do right by them. We also have, okay, let's have a card for this Empress spirit. Empress, the Empress is a perfect, you know. Yeah, she wants to come out of this hermit mode now. She wants to go out there and see what else is out there for her now. The Empress is the queen of all queens. She's mastered, you know, there's a queen, the queen of wands, queen of pentacles, there's a queen of wands, queen of swords. So she's got all the best things of all the queens. So she's the queen of all queens, as we call them in tarot language. So she is done with this relationship altogether, and she is wanting to come out of this hermit mode with this King of Wands, who, you know, did not fulfill any promises. This he promised more than he could deliver, and she felt totally left out in the cold by the end of it, or she left him out in the cold possibly, and moved on. So give us a card for the King of Wands spirit. Please give us a card for the King of Wands in reverse, for person B. Yes, this person was weak-minded, okay? Did not hold on to the relationship with the strength and, the effort required. They were wishy-washy probably. They promised more than they could do. They did not nurture the relationship. There was weakness which set in into this relationship. And the Empress, or the right person on the right, felt that, you know, felt abandoned by the King of Wands, and had made a decision to leave, and maybe even left. Yes, left to see what else is out there for them. Okay, looked out into the big wide world and with a globe in their hand is to see, okay, now what should I do next? And, you know, release all this pain, this conflict, this heartbreak, you know, the sadness, and leave it all behind. So in your mutual energy, what do we have now? We have the first card is the death card, which could mean this relationship is over. Okay, both of you feeling now there's no going back to this relationship, and there's no point in offering any more love or affection, because both, or at least one of them, feels that the other is not going to accept it. Okay, the stagnation to a point where it seems that the relationship seems over. But even so, I see one or the other or both still checking up on the other person. Okay, they're checking up on the other person to see where the other person is, what they're doing. Give us a card for the Page of Swords, please. Yes, both feel that injustice has been done to them or to this relationship. And or maybe there was a court case which ended up in divorce, or is ending in divorce, and maybe they're far away and just kind of keeping a watch on each other, unwilling to totally let this go, yet knowing that, you know, it's over and there is no return to this. Give us one more card for the page. Yeah, both have realized it's time now to walk away. Okay, there is no going back to this, something which is over and done. It's really no point waiting around for this. This isn't the mutual energy. So I think both are coming to the realization. Both are putting down this burden, and what is over is over. We also have the Queen of Wands here. Now the Queen of Wands in your mutual energy, is that how you both see each other, or how one sees the other and the other is? Queen of Wands is a dynamic queen. She's a go-getter. She, you know, fends for herself. She's creative. She's inspiring. Okay, so they both realize that this was a match which was not meant to be. I have the King of Wands in reverse and the Queen of Wands upright. So both have now come to the realization that this was not a match which was in alignment. And that is why it is over. Anything else? Yes, both releasing this now. This week, finally, if you've been struggling to let go of a relationship, or struggling to get away from somebody and close out a cycle, I think this is over. See, in the first card itself, I had the Wheel of Fortune in reverse, okay? Not wanting to close out the cycle, but I think this week, finally, you both are letting this go totally, realizing it's over. So that's what I have for you here, but I will take one blessing card for you, Sagittarius, to see how the angels can provide support at this difficult time for you or your cross watcher or both of you. Yes, when a relationship ends, it does leave, you know, pain for both parties. Even if one wants to and the other doesn't want to, it's no relationship is ends without pain. So what the angels are saying, that now is a time to recommit back to yourself. Okay, it's time to take your life back in control, and instead of just thinking of what the other person is doing, how the other person is moving ahead, it's time to, you know, bring the focus back to yourself, nurture yourself, commit to yourself moving ahead in a healthy, prosperous way. Let me take one more card for you. Sagittarius, please do subscribe. I will be coming out with your love readings. So who knows, you know, if this relationship is on, you know, coming to an end, we'll check up to see what new is coming your way. And because that's the rule of the universe, one door closes, another opens. And it just takes time for you to think that, or to you to will that door to close. Till you keep holding on to this energy, which is, you know, not wanting the cycle to close, nothing new will enter. So let it go now. Let it go so that something new and fabulous energy can come into your life. You Sagittarians are so beautiful. You know, you're full of life and spiritual people. I'm sure there's something wonderful new waiting for you. So let's take another card for you, Sagittarius. Signs from above. Okay, so if you have been getting signs and synchronicities, that this, you know, maybe you've been checking up on this person and you've been seeing that this person is looking happy and moving ahead or whatever, take that as a sign that it's time now to totally retreat from this energy. And also keep a lookout if, you know, you're getting any signs, physical signs from the universe, as in repeating numbers or feathers and butterflies and songs that play out on the radio, repeating numbers, like I said. So all these are signs from the universe that you're not alone. Even at this difficult, dark time of your life that you may be going through, the universe and the angels are trying to get in touch with you, reach your heart. But if you are negative in your heart, they can't send you those signs and synchronicities. Okay? So clear your energy, recommit to yourself, do some yoga or some meditation, cleanse your heart and soul so that the angels can get through to you to bring you wonderful, wonderful new beginnings in your life. Okay? So take care and love and light. See you next time.